Good afternoon. I'm representing Karnataka Learning Partnership. We are an initiative of Akshara Foundation. You might have seen our logo earlier on the sponsorship board, so that's how we know. Akshara Foundation is known for its 10 years of, over 10 years of work in government schools and preschools now. So I just run you through what KLP is, what Akshara Foundation has been doing, and what is our interest in data, what are data practices at me, and a call for collaboration. I need to read these slides myself, sir. KLP, as we envision it, is a public platform for NGOs and, let me say, participants of the public education system who work in various aspects of it. So we are proposing that it's a public platform where people can partner over public education data. And like it says, it's a network of, we are hoping for a network of non-profits, even researchers, individuals, interested individuals who work in multiple verticals within public education, learning itself, health, nutrition. And right now, we are a technology platform, a web-based platform right now, where people can share data, and it's a common public platform for community-led ownership, as we'd like to believe this is, of public education. So, Akshara Foundation is the primary partner of KLP, and it's anchoring this initiative with 10 years of experience in government schools and preschools. So, what Akshara Foundation does, as a primary partner, much of our database is actually dependent, right now, is built with Akshara's data over the last 10 years. So, 5 key programs in schools and in preschools. They run reading programs in Kannada and Urdu. Math programs, which started off as remedial math programs, but now it's called a program called Akshara Ganita. Then English. We have a comprehensive network of libraries in Bangalore, and they are slowly being handed over to the government, but Akshara anchored this, and preschool education is currently a big focus with Akshara Foundation. A lot of these programs have been like proof of concept, and they've been adopted by the government to like take it into the curriculum itself. So that's the success of some of these programs. They have a strong research and evaluation team, and this core technology team that will serve as the advocacy framework we hope, which we call Karnataka Learning Partnership. So, in terms of, sorry, I have a back door, so I'm going to go along this way. What underlies, what data underlies KLP? So, if you look to the left, we have Akshara's master database. 10 years of school intervention, we have a lot of data that we have collected in public schools based on the programs that were done. As a separate exercise, we have lat longs of all schools in Bangalore. We have constituency and ward information per school. And we can even aggregate this against public data such as DICE, which is, if any of you have heard of DICE, District Information System for Education, it's called, it's a government owned, or it's government run organization called NUPA, who publishes information about schools across India. So, we can actually build views on all these other databases that are either public or data that we have collected, and a large amount of our data comes from the Akshara database. So if you see what feeds into the KLP platform today is a subset of Akshara's data. Akshara is like child level data that we anonymize and bring into the KLP platform, and as I said, views on the other databases. So what's an Akshara's DD? So school and student information across 20 districts in Karnataka. We have about 2,000 odd preschools in Bangalore, Harvard and Koppal. We have details like medium of instruction, category, like even within preschools there are categories. There are Balwadis, Anganwadis, and so the categories. And then there are 47,000 odd active students across the preschools. We have information, we have actually information like child name, relations, father, mother, brother, sibling, names and all of that, but we anonymize much of it. And we have, we collect gender, date of birth, class. There are about 20,600 schools across these 20 districts in Karnataka that are in the database, the records in our database today. 6.75 lakh student records. We've done, Akshara Foundation has done 27 programs and 71 assessments. So each of our programs is a detailed school intervention, which is like preceded by a pre-test and a post-test. They are the assessments that I'm talking about. So, and some of them will have multiple assessments. So a year-long program with several intermediate assessments. So 27 programs, 71 assessments since 2006, and so about 10 million records just leaving students to answers of these. Yeah, there's a status on there. So if the school was deactivated or the class that they were in was deactivated for some reason, then their status is inactive. So it's a query that we ran to figure out who is active, who are the children who are active. It's based on all the entities that they have relationships being active. So this is a snapshot as of March of this year. And this database continues to grow. So how do we manage data? I think Akshara has had an experience with Palm Pilots and OMRs and all of that. But I think the most time-tested method, which is paper-based data collection, has worked best for Akshara. You see that huge pile of paper that really happens every time we have like a pre-test or a post-test cycle. And we have a MIS system that we correctly use for data entry. And pretty much what one sees on a sheet, it goes into a school and conducts a test, collects child level information and the score per whatever question that was asked, is exactly replicated on an application interface, which they just enter exactly that same data entry. So we've tried and made an effort to make the sheet look exactly, the UI look exactly like the sheet. So there's minimum error rate and all of that. And all of this feeds into Akshara's Postgres master database. So, and I'm happy for this to be a conversation because I'm not much of a talker. So if you have questions, please ask me. So, how often does the database get updated? So Akshara runs a minimum of at least there are two assessments per program, and at a minimum right now we are running three programs a year, the English, the math and the reading. The program revisits the same geography at least once in 3 years. So if you've done an English program in the north of Bangalore this year, it's highly likely or if it was done in like say 2009, highly likely this year we revisit with that geography. So we don't have year-on-year continuous data, but if you're looking at something like looking at English reading patterns over the last 5 minutes. 5 minutes?
Yeah.
I just started.
She just started. Oh, it's okay then.
Just let me know when I alright. So we don't have continuous data on the same level. And how does this, how do we, like this constant discovery of new students when you enter a new geography, or if there was a pre-test and a post-test happened, any new students who were discovered or any new boundaries or schools that were discovered during the process, they keep getting upgraded in the database. One of the, just a small metric that I wanted to show you is that in 2010, when we did an Anganwadi study, we found 30,000 students in the pre-test, and the delta was less than 9%. You know, we actually could trace most of them in the post-test. So if anybody wants to do a study on that kind of the Anganwadi learning set, the data set that we have, it's fairly, you have enough records to like run your studies now. For us, what a partnership means is that we have more geographies, more programs, there'll be more schools, students, and this whole database can become more comprehensive. Just a note that in the last 5 months alone, in a pre-test cycle of English, Maths, and Anganwadi data, we have touched 2.5 million database records. So this ensures, this contributes to the quality of the data as well. So this is a fairly high touch exercise. So we revisit the database so often that it's likely that there are mistakes that are getting corrected. And this is a slide on how we further ensure quality. So if you look at, I probably it's a little too full of images. So I'll just try to bring out the validation layers. This is the Postgres master database of Aksharas, right? And we frequently have people within Akshara looking at this database. We have frequent programs, surveys that, you know, pick up data from this database and feed it back in. So one of the beliefs is that many eyes looking at this database means that this data is getting validated. The KLP platform itself reads from this master database. We have a MIS system which has at the entry point checks for validation and a process called double entry, where we make sure that all the data we enter is double entered or is cross verified, and that inherently improves the quality of the data. Even before it feeds into the database, there's another level of validation. We have, on the other side, we have researchers, visualization enthusiasts, such as people in this room, like the MIS developers, ourselves. We have people who bring in partner data. We have a few partners on the cards right now. And whenever their data comes in, we need to match up our school level information or student level information with them. And that, in turn, that whole exercise brings in another level of validation. Is it the right, say, information associated with the school? They may have something different, we may have something different to kind of correlate. We also have similar exercises with like a public database like ISDB. So this whole bunch of validations, we believe that transactions in and out of this database are improving the quality of the data itself. What does Akshara use this data for? Primarily, Akshara has a research and evaluation team, and they've brought out a couple of reports in the last 3-4 years. One is the Bangalore education profile, you can find on the Akshara website. There's also the Urdu school report, which was a study only on Urdu schools. A large part of these interventions that happen and the data that's kept in our database goes back, feeds back into program design. At some level, because the programs are so closely in school and the interventions really, a learning level evaluation is frequently happening. Many of these programs are proof of concept. Akshara's programs are proof of concept that the government will take in and introduce into their own curriculum. So it's kind of advocacy at the pedagogy level. What does KLP do with the data? So I told you earlier that we have pretty much all schools and preschools in Bangalore, the education district map. So I'm not sure if you can see it, but if you click on it, this is an overlay on a Google map. You There's an overlay on Google Map. So if you click on any of these markers, you can actually go and get in-depth information about a school. So school page is a comprehensive page with school location, demographics of a school, what are the programs that were done in a school. In fact, if you blow in, you go in further and drill down into the program information, you can actually see the learning assessments that were done in the schools. And this for at least all the schools in Bangalore. And we hope to plot all of the schools in Karnataka onto this map soon. We have also brought out reports like the recent thing that we brought out are these MP MLA constituency wise reports. The one on demographics is published and it is available on the website. So for a constituency, what are the number of schools and what are the demographics of that school of those schools? And then we have a report on financial allocation, one on infrastructure, school infrastructure, and one on learning levels, which are not yet public, but they are in the making. We have raw CSV dumps, some of them readily available for data enthusiasts to pick up and draw visualizations on, and some can be made available on demand. So, and then this is one feature on the website where, which we call Share Your Story, which is open to volunteers or people who work with schools. And the primary intention is that it's an evaluation of how RTE compliant the school is. So RTE and ICDS prescribe that a school should have a certain level of infrastructure, and we put out those questions there for volunteers to go out and see if it exists in the school. They come back and check it and provide us pictures and such. And this, we think, can be a way of validating even what DICE says about RTE, about schools, right?
How do you check for the usage of toilets, for example?
I think this is something they'll have to ask. Because one visit during a school hour will not be able to tell you
that.
We can't. Unless somebody repeatedly does, or does a toilet survey alone or something like that, then you can ask more details. So these questions, the responses are moderated and they're actually presented on the school information pages that I showed you. So who uses KLP today? Much of the volunteering for the Akshara programs brings in information through the Share Your Story. The maps and the school information page I showed you earlier form the backbone of that volunteering. There are partners, both government and non-government organizations, some individuals, researchers, data enthusiasts who show an interest in education and want to work with our data. And as an internal tool, it's working great for us. But we would want to reach out to other stakeholders. For example, there are other formats, right? So we can work with mobile and print. And with the MP MLAs, we realized to send them a report in print is the best way to do it. And that's been done. But we'd like to work with parents and teachers and communities who are probably not so web savvy. So we'd like to explore other platforms. These are some of the visualizations that have been done by data enthusiasts, some of them in this group. We would like to see many more of these. The only challenge is how to cater to the least common denominator, how to create a report probably or some kind of a campaign that will hit the parent in the eye, you know, or somebody who could demand better quality of this public education system. So, but this is a general bunch of visualizations that people have done for us on how to rate schools, how to rate the learning levels. So what are the plans? We plan to extend the web-based platform, bringing map overlays, constituency shapes, and this hearty compliance of whether schools lie within 2 kilometer radius of each other. We want to bring in a mobile-based platform where teachers and community can bring in partners and hence make the data more comprehensive. Involve NGOs, civil society, and volunteering, government. We want to extend the data model. We have a tried and tested method of collecting data, the processes, the validation, the representation is all in place. So it's something that any NGO who's already working with schools today can pick up. Or if anybody is interested in working in a different geography than us, they can pick up and put it in place. So we are trying to build a strong core platform for maintaining this master data about schools. We want to facilitate a federated model of open source, others open source MIS that we have. People can enter, can manage a part of their own data as well as contribute to the master data about the Karnataka's government schools and things. So hopefully at the end of it all, we'll facilitate a community-owned advocacy platform for monitoring and improving public education. So what the call for collaboration here is from people who are interested, who are from the research or the academic community. If you're working with a non-profit or if you're with the Department of Education, you want to share any education or you need any information from our platform, do get in touch. If you're a data visualization mapping enthusiast who can help us report our data more effectively, do get in touch. If you're a technology enthusiast who wants to review our code from time to time or participate in our design discussions, please. And we are hiring, so do chat out with me later if you're interested in what we do. If you have a subset of any of these skill sets, we work with Python, basic web technology, and all of that, and SQL and PostGIS and mapping. If you have a subset or any of these skills, do chat out. Thank you. And questions? Do we have time for questions?
Okay. If you have questions, you can meet her over there and
yes,
continue the conversation.
Yes. Thank you.